working as an assistant professor in Department of Mechanical Engineering, Walchand Institute of Technology, Solapur. In this session of a vapor compression cycle, we will study methods to improve COP. Learning outcome. At the end of this session, students will be able to describe subcooled vapor compression cycle and describe superheated vapor compression cycle. Now, there are three methods to improve COP. First one is known as subcooled VCC, second superheated VCC, and third one regenerative VCC. Here we will see first two only. In the first method to improve COP, improvement in COP requires either to increase in the refrigerating effect or decrease in the work consumption. So, first one is subcooled VCC. In the subcooled VCC, the cooling of refrigerant is to be done in the liquid region. As we know on the pH plot, this is the pressure enthalpy plot and this is the saturation curve. Standard VCC we have plotted, in which 1 to 2 is the isentropic compression, 2 to 3 is the isobaric condensation, 3 to 4 is the isenthalpic expansion process, that is a throttling process, 4 to 1 is the refrigerating effect. Now, point number 3 is on the saturated liquid curve, as this is the critical point. So, after leaving the condenser, if we will be able to move this liquid refrigerant, which is at high pressure, that is condenser pressure, in the subcooled region, this region is the liquid region, but the temperature of this region, that is liquid refrigerant, will be less than the saturation temperature, as this is the isothermal line. This is the isothermal line. So if I will be able to cool the saturated liquid on the subcooled side, then that VCC we can call it as subcooled VCC, and this refrigerant is in the subcooled region. Now, how to, can you think over the cooling of refrigerant? Which methods are there by means of which we can cool this liquid refrigerant? For same size of the condenser, we can spray for air-cooled condenser the water. By means of that, we can absorb more amount of heat than air-cooled condenser. This is the first method. In the second method, we can increase the length of condenser tube. So, for that enlarged size of the condenser, by increasing the length of the condenser tube, we'll be able to get subcooled liquid refrigerant at same pressure. So, 3 to 3 bar will be subcooling process, and the total condensation process will happen from point number 2 to point number 3 dash. This is known as subcooled 3 to 3 dash. Then this subcooled liquid refrigerant will be passed through the expansion valve, either capillary tube or thermostatic expansion valve. There will be expansion up to evaporator pressure. Let use 4 dash as the notation, then 4 dash to 1 will be the evaporation process. So what happens by subcooling the liquid refrigerant? For theoretical COP, we had written refrigerating effect divided by work consumption. So refrigerating effect was during process 4 to 1, so H1 minus H4 divided by work consumption was H2 minus H1. By getting the subcooled refrigerant, that means for subcooled VCC, suppose the notation is COP dash will be equal to QR dash divided by WC dash. Now there is change in refrigerating effect from 4 to 1 to 4 dash to 1. That's why here the refrigerating effect will get changed from H1 minus H4 to H1 minus H4 dash by work consumption is same, that is H2 minus H1. For same work consumption, there is increase in the refrigerating effect. This is increase in the refrigerating effect. So numerator is increased, denominator is same. So overall effect is increase in the COP. Though depending upon the type of the refrigerant, that is R134A, R22, R717, the effect may be minimum or measurable. So this is all about the subcooled VCC. Second type of the increase in the COP method is superheated VCC. Superheated vapor compression cycle. So what we are going to do in the superheated VCC? On pH plot, suppose this is the theoretical VCC. This is the theoretical VCC. To avoid wet compression, practically the superheating of the refrigerant before entering to the compressor is recommended. Now how to achieve that superheating? So just increase the size of the evaporator tubes. Here we increase the condenser tube, here we have to increase the evaporator tubes. Just increase the length, keep the diameter same. So we'll get the superheating from 1 to 1 dash. Now recommended practical values for subcooling and superheating is by 5 to 10 degree Celsius. For example, if the evaporator temperature is 10 degree Celsius, then we should superheat it up to plus 20 degree Celsius maximum. This is the practical recommendation. So this 1 to 1 dash is known as superheating the refrigerant. This 1 dash will enter into the compressor. There will be compression from 1 dash to 2 dash, and 2 dash to 3 will be actual condensation. So what will be its effect on the COP? Let COP double dash denotes the change in the COP. This was the theoretical COP. Now by superheating the vapor refrigerant before entering to the compressor isobarically, the change will be QR double dash divided by WC double dash. Now here new refrigerating effect is H1 double dash minus H4. This is the change in the refrigerating effect. to actual work, that is H2 double dash minus H1 double dash. Now here, as the specific volume increases, there will be change in the compression work. Also, there is increase in the refrigerating effect. For the selected refrigerant, we have to find out the change, that is increase in the refrigerating effect and increase in the work consumption. So the increase or decrease in the COP for superheating depends upon the type of the refrigerant filled or charged or used in that particular appliances. Means the superheated VCC COP may be greater than, less than or equal to, this is not possible, but we will consider equal to theoretical COP. By these two methods, we will get improvement in the COP. For further study, you can refer refrigeration and air conditioning by C.P. Arora and W.F. Stoker. Thank you.